like blood, violence, freaks of nature? Well, then come on down to Captain Spaulding's Museum of Monsters and Madmen. Yeah, see the alligator boy. Ride my famous murder ride. Most of all, don't forget to take home some of my tasty fried chicken. Ha ha! It just tastes so damn good.
What is going on, everybody? How's everybody's Sunday so far? This is a review I wanted to do earlier last week and I didn't get the chance. Today I am going to be talking about the 2003 film House of a Thousand Corpses. Now, this movie was actually made in 1999, but it got shelved by Universal. Rob Zombie, who directed this film, by the way, took it over to MGM, and MGM said, sure, we'll release it. 2 years later, they still hadn't released it. He took it from MGM, bought the rights back, and went over to Lionsgate, where Lionsgate said, you know what, we're going to fucking release this, and they finally did. And you ask me, the horror world is definitely better off for it. Regardless of what people think of Rob Zombie's other films, The House of a Thousand Corpses is a awesome fucking movie. This movie stars Sid Haig as Captain Spaulding. It stars Bill Moseley as Otis Driftwood. And it stars, at the time, Sherry Moon as Baby Firefly. Now, Sherry Moon, of course, went on to become Sherry Moon Zombie, his wife. And she just happened to star in just about every one of his films. Well, actually, she has starred in every one of his films. Which is, you know, up and down for me, but we'll get to that at a later date. Simple plot. A group of travelers fall prey to the sadistic Firefly family. It's our basic storyline. There is all kinds of shit in this movie. But before we get into all that, I want to dedicate this review. This review is dedicated to Harrison Young, Erwin Keyes, Karen Black, Dennis Fimple, Matthew McGrory, and Tom Towles. As well as, of course, the late, great Sid Haig. All of those people were in this film. And all of those people have since passed on. Which makes me wonder about the luck of working with Rob Zombie. In seriousness, though, it's really sad because so many of these people were good, awesome, talented actors who had some of them bright futures ahead of them. And some of them great careers behind them. I'm going to start off with my cons because that's where I was going with what I was saying before the dedication. This movie has so much stuff crammed into it. And I think the reasoning behind that is I don't think Rob Zombie thought he was ever going to get the chance to make a horror movie again. So he wanted to put everything he wanted into this movie. And that's how I feel about it. I do feel that the third act is kind of a mess. I do enjoy it, though. It's still a very fun, very good film. I just feel like he could have done a lot more with a lot less. If you ask me, the entire Dr. Satan ending didn't even need to be there. And it kind of added some confusion to the movie. The movie was doing really well with this sadistic killer family. To throw the Dr. Satan stuff in on top of it, and the mutant down below, Earl, and the doctor who's fucking crazy, even though it looks cool as hell, I just don't think it was all needed. I thought the movie was doing fine up to that point on its own. Now, I'm not saying I don't like this part. I'm just saying that it's very convoluted, it's very messy, and I really think, like I said, he was just trying to get as much in as he could, just in case he never got the chance to do this again. My second con is also in that sequence, and it's the muck zombies. What are these people? Are they survivors that have been thrown down into this pit and now they're surviving off the flesh of others? Are they actually zombies? Like I said, once again, too much in the movie, didn't understand that point, didn't know what was going on with those. I just don't see why they were there. And my last con for this is also that third act, once again, the complete ending reminds me of a Marilyn Manson music video. And I don't understand that. This was such a well-shot, well-done film that the ending of the movie reminded me more of a music video than a film. So I just didn't really get in on that.
Whoa, Well, howdy, folks. It's your old pal, Captain Spaulding again. Yes, I'm here to tell you about a brand new attraction, Mary the Monkey Girl. Oh, yeah, that's right. This here little honey is half real human, half monkey. I brought all the way from the wilds of Borneo. So y'all come in, make sure you bring little Johnny and Susie with you. She'll scare the holy guacamole out of them. And remember, while you're down here, pick up your Captain Spaulding for President t-shirts. Coming all shapes and sizes. Small, medium, large, and jumbo for our big bone friends. We all know how you got that way, too, huh? Yes, from eating my delicious fried chicken. Oh, yes. Just keeps getting better all the time. God bless America, and God bless Captain Spaulding.
So, getting into the pros, the acting in this film is really good. I especially like the performances of Bill Moseley and Sid Haig. My favorite part of this movie is the first 20 minutes. Sid Haig steals this movie from me. I love the music of this film. Okay, with Rob Zombie as its director, it should have a damn good soundtrack. I love all the 70s classic rock he uses. It is just such an awesome soundtrack. Usually this guy can pick really good music to fit scenes. The only place I thought he didn't do that was in Rob Zombie's Halloween and Halloween 2. But that's whole other reviews, which I've already done. If you want to check those out, go check them out. They're really good reviews. I really love the dialogue in this movie. A lot of people talk about Rob Zombie's dialogue, how dirty it is, how trashy it is. Well, in this universe, it works. In The House of a Thousand Corpses, that dialogue works. In Rob Zombie's style, when he's doing his own movies, it works. When he's doing something like Halloween, it does not work, and it should not be in that movie. He should have kept that shit out of the Halloween franchise. But once again, whole other video, don't want to get off on a rant. I love the grindhouse style that this movie is filmed in. It's gritty, it's dirty, it's grimy, it's blurry sometimes. I love that film style. It looks so good. Now, along with that grindhouse style, and even though, yes, I said blurry, but that's blurry intentionally, this movie has great cinematography. Rob Zombie showed early on in his career with this film that he was a great visual director. This guy knows how to frame a shot. He knows how to point a camera. I've said that in all of his movies. Even the ones I don't like, I've said that. I liked the recordings. I liked the, you know, it looked like almost video camera recording journal entries that were in between scenes. I thought that was really cool, and it's something that shows up in his films repeatedly. It shows up in 31, it shows up in Devil's Rejects, and it's something I really enjoyed. I thought it was a cool way to keep the story progressing. I love the gore in this movie, and I love the ferocity of the kills. This is a ferocious movie. This movie gives no fucks and holds no bars. If you love bloodbath horror, if that's what you expect in your horror movies, is gruesome blood and guts, this is your movie. Guys, overall, The House of a Thousand Corpses is a really awesome film. Now, personally, I'm a bit more fond of the sequel, but we'll get into that later as well. I do want to say, though, that I really love this movie, and I really, really love the DVD menu. I have the DVD of this, the one that folds out from way back when, the special edition, and I know that they've put the same menu on some of the other DVDs, and I fucking love it. It's absolutely awesome. It's such a cool interactive menu, and Captain Spaulding is on there giving a great performance, even on a menu. This movie is a lot of fun. It's very dark, it's very creepy, and it's fucking nuts. And I really enjoy it. Even on the bad parts, even on the things that I don't think serve the movie well, I still enjoy the movie. And that's the main point, right? Guys, that is it for my review of House of a Thousand Corpses. I want to thank everybody for watching. I want to thank my horror mob. Thank you guys for being awesome supporters. I want to give a special shout out to John Kyle Stanton. Dude, you're awesome. I really appreciate you being there for me. For those of you that don't know what the horror mob is, that is my Patreon. Go over and check it out on the Patreon page. I'll leave the link in the description box below. It's got some really cool tiers. It's really affordable. And I think you will enjoy it. Plus, you will get access to exclusive content not seen anywhere else. This is Bronco Juggalo saying peace.
Very funny.
Cool. Well, it's that time of year again when you, my friends, get to shell out all your hard-earned cash buying presents for people you don't even like. Why not buy them Murder Ride gift certificates? They'll last all year long. Bring little Timmy and Susie on down. We'll scare the tar and tarnation out of them. Oh, and by the way, when you're down there, make sure that you pick up your Captain Spaulding for President t-shirts. Come in all sizes. It's the perfect gift for that special someone or something. Oh, Merry Christmas. Ho, ho, ho. Merry Christmas. Ha, ha, ha. Merry Christmas. Spend more money. Merry Christmas right this way. Ha, ha.